So now we discuss identities. So what are the identities? That means mere we say that actually the condition identities. See, for example, here if A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees, if A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees. So now take see that side. So now here this becomes A plus B is equal to 180 degrees minus C. If you apply sine function on both sides, so let us see what do we get. So if you apply sine function on both sides, sine of A plus B is equal to sine of 180 degrees minus C. We know that the sine of 180 minus theta, sine of 180 minus theta equals to sine theta. So this sine of A plus B becomes sine C. Similarly, could you expect the remaining values? So similarly, sine of B plus C, what do you write? The sine of B plus C is equal to sine A. What is sine of C plus A? Sine of C plus A can be written as sine B. So that means if A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees, what is sine of A plus B? Sine C. What is sine of B plus C? Sine A. What is sine of C plus A? Sine B. So in the similar pattern, so suppose here instead of applying sine function, if you apply cos function, let us see what do we get, what is the result we get it. So now as we know that here A plus B is equal to 180 degrees minus C, apply cos function on both sides. If you apply the cos function on both sides, cos of A plus B is equal to cos of 180 degrees minus C. What is cos of 180 degrees minus theta? The cos of 180 degrees minus theta means 180 degrees minus theta lies in the second quadrant. We know that in the second quadrant, sine and cosecant ratios are positive, the rest of the ratios are negative, and so the cos of 180 minus theta becomes minus cos theta. So here we can write the formula, cos of 180 degrees minus theta is equal to cos theta, but minus cos theta. So cos of A plus B becomes minus cos C. So similarly the cos of C plus A equals to, what is the value of cos of C plus A? That is minus cos B, right? So cos of B plus C, so cos of B plus C is equal to minus cos A. So that means if A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees, the cos of A plus B becomes minus cos C, cos of B plus C becomes minus cos A, cos of C plus A becomes minus cos B. So now for example, let us change the condition. Here we have the condition A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees. Let us change the condition as A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. So now if we change the condition A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees or pi by 2, sometimes it may be in radians also pi by 2. So A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees. Now take C that side. this now A plus B is equal to 90 degrees minus C. Okay. Let us find out the result sine of A plus B. What is the value of sine of A plus B? So now apply sine function on both sides. Sine of A plus B is equal to sine of 90 degrees minus C. Now sine 90 degrees minus C is in the form of sine 90 degrees minus theta. So sine of 90 degrees minus C equals to cos C, or sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. So using this result, the sine of A plus B can be written as cos C. So if A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees, the result of sine of A plus B is equal to cos C. Similarly, here sine of B plus C cos A, am I correct? The sine of C plus A equals to cos B. Okay, let me repeat once again. If A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees, sine of A plus B is cos C, sine of B plus C is cos A, sine of C plus A is cos B. So now let us have the one question. So can, for example, if A plus B plus C is equal to 180, can sin C replaced by A plus sin of A plus B? Sin A is replaced by sin of B plus C? Sin of B, sin B is replaced by sin of C plus A? Why not? Yes, we can replace sin C as sin of A plus B, sin A as sin of B plus C, sin B as sin of C plus A. In the similar pattern, in this case also, if cos C is there, we can write minus cos of A plus B. Cos B is there, minus cos of C plus A. Cos A is there, minus cos of B plus C, providing these conditions. In the similar manner, for A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees also, the converse is, this is called converse, the converse is also true. Now, here, the one more, the result is to be deduced. Now, we know that A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees. Take C that side. A plus B is equal to 90 degrees minus C. This time apply cos function. If you apply the cos function, what sort of results do we get? Let us observe. So cos of A plus B, cos of 90 degrees minus C. So cos 90 degrees minus theta, that is nothing but sin theta. So cos of A plus B is equal to sin C. Similarly, let us write other results. Cos of B plus C. So could you expect what is the value of cos of B plus C? That is sin A. Now cos of C plus A, that is equal to sin B. So now one more condition. Suppose instead of A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degrees, A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees. For example, the condition is imposed as A plus B plus C is equal to 0 degrees. What sort of results do we get? So let us find the values. Let us observe. Suppose if A plus B plus C is equal to 0 degrees, A plus B equals to minus C. Apply sine function on both sides. Sine of A plus B is equal to sine of minus C. What is sine of minus theta? The sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So now this sine of A plus B equals to minus sine C. The rest of the results we can write very easily by observation. Similarly, sine of B plus C. Sine of B plus C is equal to the minus sine A, correct? Sine of C plus A equals to minus sine B. So, similarly now, if you apply the cosine function, let us apply the cosine function. Cos of A plus B is equal to cos of minus C. But cos of minus theta is plus cos theta. So, cos of A plus B is cos C. Okay? Similarly, let us write remaining results. The cos of B plus C, that is cos A. Cos of C plus A, that is cos B.